In our previous class, we learned how keyframing worked, what we can do and what we are able to achieve. It was a very basic thing that we did. We also exported that project into a video format and we saw our first video animation. Now, in this class, we are going to modify that project, add a few more layers, make it a little bit more dynamic, and again, export it the way we want so that you will be proud of the project that you have worked on. Let's jump into this one and see what we have. So in our previous class, you know that on our timeline, I'm just going to disable the audio here, which is this option. So we won't see the audio timeline. We only see the images. We know that this was our basic animation that we actually did, but we only added keyframes to one element in our group, which is Woody. We disabled Rocket and we did not do anything with Rocket. Now, if I disable Woody, you will not see anything happening on this video. It's empty. But if I enable Woody, that same keyframe will be there because that information is actually embedded on our timeline. Let's say if I want to disable this, all I need to do is I want to remove the keyframes. By what I mean by disable, I click on this, I press delete, I click on this keyframe and press delete, and it's gone. So Woody will not be doing anything. So I'm not going to work on Woody for this one. So I'm just going to disable Woody and work on Rocket. Now, let me bring Rocket here a little bit. Sorry, I'm still working on Woody. I'm just going to click on Rocket so that it's highlighted. I'm going to bring Rocket here. You see this handle? I can always rotate Rocket. I can also increase or decrease the size uniformly by pressing shift key and holding this and dragging up and down. You should be able to actually do that on your project as well. Now, what I want to do is I actually want to move Rocket from here to here. Now, there are a few things. Let me just zoom in. If I go into my inspector, this will be a good example to learn what inspector is able to do. You've got a lot of options here. You've got scaling, you can scale it up or down. You also have position X and Y. You also have opacity. You see, imagine you are working on a sequence where all of a sudden the rocket ship appears. You can actually do that using keyframes. You see these keyframes here? You can, each one of these settings or modules have a keyframe. You can add a keyframe, do something, move your playhead in your timeline, and you will be able to actually produce something that is amazing. For example, for opacity, I can increase or decrease, and I can choose keyframes that will actually work on it. We're gonna work on that in a short while. We've got positions here, and then there's a drop down menu that you can work on. So X and Y, which for 3D animation, X and Y. So Y and X, you can see that all these modules you'll be able to actually play with. But there's one more called Z. Now, this is mostly for 3D objects, but you can also work on 2D objects that can be moved in the Z space. It's mostly bringing them closer and taking them farther, mostly work like that. But it's a very interesting thing and it works really well with 3D objects, and you will be able to actually see that. But it also works great with 2D objects. So I'm just gonna press zero on that. And what I'm gonna do is I am going to start animating our project. Okay, what I want is I want my playhead to begin here and I want Rocket to be somewhere here. That is where the rocket is going to begin. I'm going to add a keyframe here on X and Y axis because I only want X and Y axis, I don't want Z axis. And I'll move my playhead to somewhere, let's say 5 seconds. Now, I will move this all the way here. 5 seconds, and the keyframe will be added automatically for me. Now, I press play. My rocket is moving and it stops here. Now, I am only adding keyframes on the rocket. Let's work on the background that we have. I can do exactly the same things on the background. I can click on background and go into the properties for that background and play with X and Y axis as well. So let me just zoom out a little bit. Let's see if the rocket is moving this way. I want my clouds to move in the opposite direction. Okay, this is where I want the clouds to begin, and I'm going to put keyframe on X and Y axis. And then I'm going to move it all the way here, where that, you know, maybe I move a little bit more, and then move my clouds in the opposite direction. Drag and hold. Now our clouds are moving and our rocket is also moving. So let's see how this animation looks like. We have keyframes on all. If I want the animation to last longer, I can always drag the keyframes for the cloud and they will be moving slower than before. But even if my rocket is in one position, it will give us the illusion that our rocket is still moving in space. You can see that. Isn't that amazing? It's so good. I mean, it's so simple, and it's an amazing thing that you can actually work on. Okay, another thing that we are going to do is we are going to enter our library here, and we will work on some particle emitters. What I'm looking for is campfire, burning match. Okay, I'm looking for a burning match. Once I have burning match, I click on rocket that I want this to work on. I will click on rocket, the object that I want this to work on, click on burning match and click apply. Now I've got this burning match thing appearing on my timeline like this. You can see that it's a flame that actually burns. Now this is an object or an item just like any other item or any other element on my timeline, and I can always move it in different places. So I can click on this and you can actually see that I have this, and I can you know where I'm going with this. I can always rotate this. Maybe I want to move it a little bit here. Okay, and let's do something interesting here. All right, I know that this is where my rocket is going to come and stop, right? What I'll do is I will bring the match here and match it on the timeline. So this is where I want this burning match sort of particle emitter to appear, and I want to attach this near the rocket like this. Interesting. And then I can also increase the size a little bit, maybe, and bring it here. Let's see what happens. We know that our animation is working. Let's go back. The rocket comes and it's flying, and then all of a sudden, so that is a very beautiful piece of very simple animation that we just did. We worked on the inbuilt library, we took things from there. You can see that it actually stopped after a while. I can always extend this to the end of my timeline, and once it's extended, it will keep burning. The flame will be burning until the video actually stops. So it's a very basic and simple animation that we just did. Let's do it from the beginning. Let's see it from the beginning and see what we have. So a rocket comes in, coming in. And then all of a sudden we have this object. Now let's export this and see how it actually looks like. Click on export, export movie, and settings, S264, click next. It's asking me to select class animation 2. Let's watch this animation. Nice, it's very simple, it's very basic, and this is what we are able to actually do with keyframes. And there are a lot of things you can do with keyframing, but if you are doing animation, keyframing is something that you'll be working on most of the time. You can see that our rocket is still burning, and it's a very beautiful video that we actually worked on, and everything is within this folder, and it's absolutely amazing. In our next class, we'll learn about lights and how you can actually use inbuilt lights that we have, and work on some amazing text animations also. I'll see you in the next one.